Good morning, children. Welcome to your new academic year. 8th class science part we are dividing into 3: physics, chemistry, and biology. Till 7th, you studied all together as a general science. But in 8th class, it will be separated for studies and for detailed studies like I told you we are doing. Physics part chapter 11, force and pressure. This is the chapter we are learning, force and pressure. First chapter, starting in your textbook, chapter 11, force and pressure. Here topic has written force only, but chapter name force and pressure. So dear children, what is force? Some idea you have in your day-to-day life. We come across number of tasks, maybe taking things, picking things, we say, then kicking when you play, kick the ball, then hit the ball, cricket play time, hitting, very important, hitting, picking, then pushing, pulling. So I am telling number of tasks in that you are doing in your day-to-day life, flicking. These all classify into two. We can classify generally as two. One is push or pull. Push or pull. There are two classifications, push or pull. So this push or pull is termed as force. This is a definition in science. So what is force in science? A push or pull acted on the object or by the object is called a force. So force we can define in science as a push or pull. That push or pull, when we do in different forms, that we are telling picking things. So that force only they are exerting. They are all, when you observe, we need two objects in contact or interaction. There is an interaction. Sometimes there may be contact or without contact. That you will study in detail. So anyway, two objects should be in interaction. So interaction of two objects make force into play. If a car is placed on a road, one car is lying on a road, then you are standing back of the car. There is no force operating there. When we push the car, they are pushing. We can make to move a certain distance. So pushing is a task that is a force. That force they are exerted on that. When we are pressing an inflated balloon, we can change the shape of the balloon by applying force. There are also interaction between balloon and you. So when two bodies, there is an interaction of two bodies, minimum two bodies, come into play when force applied. In your textbook, I told you there are number of examples, so you can see in your textbook. When you make a chapati, you know, ball shaped duck, when we press it only, it will be the form of chapati. So force applied there on the ball duck can change its shape, so that here force we termed as pushing or pulling. So generally this is a experience you have, number of experience in your house, in your day-to-day life, force. So we need to apply force in different places. So force has very important role in our day-to-day life. Next, in your textbook, explain what are the effects of force. same side another person is pushing. So effort are the two forces acting simultaneously at the same time. Simultaneously means at the same time. So that what will happen to this box? It will move to certain distance. It will move to certain distance. So here total force is F1 plus F2. It is a net force. Net force or total force. So forces here adding. On the other hand, F1 acting in one direction, F2 acting in opposite direction. Two forces acting in opposite direction. Here what will happen? Net force is difference F2 minus F1. Or what is the difference between? That difference, which side it will, have greater force? Suppose F1 is greater than F2, it will move to this side. Reverse means this side it will move. So depend on the difference. If difference can be 0, F1 and F2 equal, then what will be difference? F1 and F2 equal. Difference is 0. So what will happen to this box? It cannot move to any side. It will be same place, position. It is a very important game during Onam, Takkopa. Takkopa, you know. This game, when rope pulling both sides, the opposite teams equally applying force, then both teams applying equal force, it cannot make to move. The center ribbon cannot make to move. They are equal forces. On the other hand, one team applying more force than other. So which team applying more force, it will move to that side and that team will be the winner of the game. So tug of war is an important game to understand the force. Then, dear children, I explained what are the effect of force. Some detail I am going to explain in the examples. There are few effects of force mentioned in your textbook. First one, a force may move an object from rest. During the football play time, penalty kick, you know, ball will be at the center position. Then, or near the goal post, that position wherever will be. Then, ball at rest. The player when kicks the ball, it will move into goal post. There, ball at rest initially, due to the kicking, means force applied, it will move to goal post. So, force can make the object to move from rest. Force can make object to move from rest. Similarly, we can increase the speed. Increase or decrease the speed. We can increase speed or decrease speed. This is also we are applying in the football play time. There we can increase the speed or decrease the speed. Then next we can change direction. Change direction. Then change shape. Shape can be changed. Some force can make object to move from rest. We can change speed. Increase or decrease? Generally we can write it change speed. So we can change speed. Similarly, we can change direction, change shape. These are the some applications of force in our daily life. We can apply force so that this effects will be obtained. Force can make the object to move from rest. Similarly, we can change speed, we can change direction, we can change shape. So these are the effects of force. Dear children, first chapter, very simple chapter only. So what is force? What are the effects of force? These two questions only. Mainly I explained about these questions. First one, what is force? Force is a form of push or pull. Then what are the effects of force? Force can make object to move from rest. It can change speed, change direction, change shape. So dear children, first part you read from textbook, important points underline. Then whatever notes giving, copy in your notebook. You must have a separate notebook for physics. Not all together in a one notebook. Notebook will be called into for here for correction. So you have to bring a notebook as we are telling, according to the time we are telling. So separate notebook, neatly you have to handle notebook. You write it neatly with the date. So dear children, you have to write in a neat handwriting. Study regularly, watch the class. Again, if you have any doubt, please call me and make clear your doubts. Thank you.